Hi, I'm Charlie Lemmy, and welcome back to another episode of Coffee House Conversations, where we have relaxing music and my voice, which isn't that relaxing. Today we're going to be talking about, is history repeating itself? Okay, I want you to pretend right now that you are in the 1960s. JFK is the president, and there is a lot of cultural riots going on, you could say, which is the civil rights movement. And now this is mostly for other race rights and stuff like that. It's a very interesting time period. I highly suggest you study it. It's very cool. But during this time period, there are riots, and there are protests pretty much across the country. During this time, it seems the government has turned a blind eye to all these protests and or riots, and they don't seem like they're doing much, but the protests still go on, and people are fighting for the rights, as I said earlier. Now you may be wondering, how does this relate to today? Well, we can look, say, gun laws. You can see riots, protests, all that over America, and it was seen back in April, I think. April, March is when all that was going on, and still is going on, and yet there's yet to be some big gun reform going on. And that's, again, the government paying a blind eye to what's going on. You can also see it with the civil rights movements compared today with Black Lives Matter, again, a race equality organization, you could say. I mean, back then, you could say it was the NAACP, but I wouldn't say Black Lives Matter to that extent. But still, it's history repeating itself. There's still more civil rights going on, if it even ended. Also, during this time period, the 60s, what we're gonna mostly focus on, we can see the outcry against the Vietnam War. Now, there are no major wars going on. Well, America is partaking in at the moment in 2018. I mean, you could consider the war on terrorism, but I'd say that's pretty much one of the smallest wars we fought in. But there's still an outcry against guns and violence, and that's what the protests against Vietnam were. You can see them in like those protests where hippies are there and they're holding up signs, or people are marching down the streets with peace signs. That's where the peace sign originated, pretty much. In Grappe. I would also like to talk about the technological revolution kind of going on right now with the cellular devices and Bluetooth. This can also be seen during the 50s with the TV and cars becoming really big, and those moving into homes and becoming smaller and smaller, just like our phones are becoming smaller and smaller. Now the thing that really sparked my interest in this history repeating itself is this book right here, Fahrenheit 451. It's a dystopian future society type of thing. And the person who wrote it, I think it's Bradbury? Let me see. Ray Bradbury is the writer of Fahrenheit 451. It was written in the 1950s, and it pretty much nails what our society is like right now. It's everyone in their phones or TVs and stuff like that. Now on the topic of wars, I would like to talk about Iraq and the Middle East. In 1979, Soviet Russia invaded Iraq, which probably most of you do not know. But this can be seen happening again in 2001 with the US invading Iraq, another world superpower. And also really into the Cold War, I feel we're going into a second cold-ish war, you could say, maybe not to the extent of the first one, but tensions are raised between the US and Russia right now. And it's an interesting conflict to look at. And I'd also like to talk about fashion. I see fashion is kind of going in a more radical direction, just like it was in the 80s. Now, don't get me wrong, 80s fashion is comedic, to say the least. And now, like modern day fashion shows, you just see those pictures where the people are wearing the funniest outfits. It's great. But I also think normal stuff people wear, like bigger sweatshirts, is also coming back into play, just like they were in the 80s and 90s. Once again, history repeating itself. Now to finish this coffeehouse conversation, I just want to say that if you do look at history, there is a pattern between events and stuff that will happen later, and stuff that's already happened. There is correlation between them, and sometimes it does really repeat itself. I don't know if these are actual things going on, or continuities, you could say, not changes, between history and now, but it's just something I thought I'd talk about on here, and tell me what you think about it. I thought it was something interesting. Well, that's gonna end it for this short coffee house conversation. Maybe I'll turn this into a weekly thing. They're fun little things to make. And well, thanks for watching. See you next week, maybe?